I'm sorry. You know, I mock a lot of the things you say, and you don't sound anything like what I'm doing.
Oh, no, that's fine. And the only way that it affects me is I do it to other people too, and they probably can affect it.
The only way it affects me is it slowly chips away at my well-being until one day I'm probably just gonna kill myself.
Listen, Justin, I mean, it's not a big deal. I mean, your boy B, he can take a joke. The only way it really affects me is that sometimes I beat my son.
But he's fine. All right. What's he there for if not that? What's up, everybody? Jay Barino here. We're getting started with the Damage Per Second podcast. I think it's week 16, but to be honest, I didn't even upload last week's yet, so I have no idea if it's 16 or 17. Negligence, corruption, all sorts of bad things happening here at the Damage Per Second podcast. Look, I would tell you more, but I don't want to implicate you or anything like that. So this week, I'm here with Keith and Brett, two big newcomers to the scene.
I'm Keith, a big newcomer to the...
I'm a little nervous. It's my first time on podcast, and I'm pretty nervous.
Well, all right. You know, I'd like to start myself with what I've been playing, but frankly, it's been a real boring week, and I was kind of sick. So someone else starts so I can give this a little... some thoughts, you know?
All right. I guess I'll start.
Yeah.
Keith's not talking. Street Fighter V released the much-anticipated March update, and it's now April. And it's actually not a bad update. They added a new character. They also added the store where you can buy nice costumes for your guys and stuff. But it's pretty interesting because you can't actually purchase anything with money yet. That's a different type of currency called Zenny. So they literally won't let you give them money. Yeah, that's the words. And Yeah, Capcom doesn't want your money yet, so they're still hiding like a bunch of these cool costumes and colors and stuff. And all the stuff they have on now you buy with fight money, which you just get by like playing the single player content. And speaking of single player content, they did add some, they have like this combo mode where you learn cool combos, but the story mode is still not there. So if you're trying to not be an esports fighter, the game is not in a state that you want to buy it in. But I mean, other than that, it works well. The new character's cool. I don't play him, but you know, that's pretty much all I've been playing, like, all week.
Wait, though, let me get this straight. They introduced an in-game currency, so it's money, and it's called Zenny.
Yeah.
Is that not just fucking hilarious to anybody else?
I think it's a reference to some Capcom baloney bullshit, but who knows what that means. It sounds really stupid. You'd think they would just put a dollar amount to that, but I think there's got to be some psychological thing with, like, not calling your dollars dollars, you know, because...
Yeah.
You guys probably don't remember, but the Xbox 360 had Microsoft points, and so you'd spend $20 and get 2,400 Microsoft points. And it's like, you get these points, and you're like, what the fuck is the point of this? Why can't I just pay real money? Like, you'd have to, like, spend $5 to buy something for $2.50 because they want you to get a certain number of points and all this bullshit. And that, the whole other types of currency thing is absolutely insane.
I mean, don't get me wrong.
Fight
I understand
money and Zenny.
I mean, I understand the in-game currency concept. It's just, it's called Zenny.
Zenny. Which is Zenny. Just... It's called Zenny, dude. Maybe you'll have a different output if you pronounce it right.
So, guys, we have to call this something other than money. How about we call them, rather than money, we'll call them monkeys. So you have to spend 5 monkeys if you want this content. Like, that's the general concept, it seems like. Like, that's what they went with. Somebody came up with that on, like, an early conference call, and they just went with it. Fucking Zenny.
Zenny, I believe, is an actual world currency, or it's from Mega Man 3D. See, that sounds a little more likely.
It says Zenny was the name of a bronze coin in ancient Japan.
Oh, okay. I mean, yeah, I'll give Drachmanden the benefit of the doubt, saying he believes it's an actual world currency, but, you know, on the alternate side, he says it's either a world currency or it's from Mega Man 3D. That's a pretty big discrepancy, if you ask me.
Actually, kind of related to that, I forgot. I've been playing Guitar Hero Live a ton, which I haven't even talked about on this podcast, but I've played a lot of Guitar Hero in my time. And this Guitar Hero is really cool. It changes up a lot of the ways that you play that game and whatnot. But they have this similar situation where there's two types of currencies in the game, one you earn from playing the game and one that you buy. But the one that you buy, which is called Hero Cash, which makes a lot more sense than Zenny, it's like they don't let you buy the things that'll make you like actually be able to compete in the game. So they just released this Rivals Arena where you face off against somebody else and you get to, you start at Division 20 and then you work your way up all the way through Division 1 by earning tokens with each victory. It's a pretty simple ranked system, but so I keep losing because my guitar is not fully upgraded or I haven't spent my coins on like different multipliers and different hero powers to make my score multiplier higher. And so it's just ridiculous because I would probably put up to like $20 just to make it so that I could actually compete with like a fully upgraded guitar when people are just beating me because they've played more of the game and had more tokens. But I can't spend my real money on those things. All you can spend real money on is like plays. And it's such baloney. Like, it's so backwards to me that they wouldn't let you pay money for anything that they offer in that store rather than just like certain things.
It's dumb and weird.
Yeah.
It is dumb and weird.
Right, you gotta spend them coins!
Ugh, it's so annoying. Grinding it out. I'm finally like, I'm getting close. I'm Division 3 now, so we're almost there. Once I get to 1, I'm probably never gonna play it again because it's so frustrating to lose to somebody who doesn't play as well as I do. But, oh, they used 6 different hero powers because they have the upgrade path which, like, doesn't limit your hero powers. Oh, that's so stupid. You guys probably have nothing to say about this, but it just pisses me off.
Well, no, I mean, it sounds like a dumb, like, so it's not exactly, like, I don't know. I just don't really see any scenario where, like, hey, you should get a higher score even though you did worse.
Yeah,
yeah, it sounds like a mobile game.
I think that should intuitively be something that they know that, like, Guitar Hero players don't want.
Yeah, it sounds like a mobile, like a pay-to-win mobile game situation.
Yeah, it's totally like that. But it's the worst part of it is you can't even pay to win because the parts that require you to win are only earned by playing the game. So I can't even put my real money into it. Like, I have, I bought, like, $4 worth of this cash and I still haven't used it all. Because there's just barely anything to use it on.
Oh, I get it, Brett. So you're just saying you're so good, you don't even have to play the game. So you're that guy telling everyone else, oh, get good, get good. My name's Brett. I'm so good. So who
and
cares?
I can't even win.
I don't need to play that much to be good at this game. That's what you're saying, right?
Yeah.
Like, now that I think about it, that guy did tell me his name was Brett. I should have put 2 and 2 together.
My name's Brett, and you need to get good.
My name's Brett. I'm great. You need to get a little better.
Get a little better. Yeah, I don't know. I've just been getting frustrated with all games lately, I feel like, because I can't get to rank 1 or whatever, Division 1 in Guitar Hero because of these upgrades, and then I can't figure out what character I want to play in Street Fighter, so I just keep losing. It's like, it's annoying. Maybe I should
all right, it's because you can't figure out what character to play. That's why.
I'm definitely not good either.
That's why you're losing. No, I understand. I understand.
Like, you know, you got to find the right character to play so you get that groove where you want to keep playing and you're improving and stuff.
Yeah, man, absolutely.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
I don't know. That's what I've been playing, though. And I don't know if... Yeah, I'll put a third in there. I really want this game that comes out tomorrow... or Tuesday for those listening in the future, enter the Gungeon, which looks
excited.
Yeah, it looks like Nuclear Throne, but in a more like a dungeon setting. It looks like the enemies are all bullets, and you get really sweet looking weapons, and it looks exactly like Nuclear Throne though. When Jay Barino pointed that out at they really look the same. I don't know if it's not the same company, but I'm looking forward to it. I haven't pre-ordered it yet, but I think I'm going to.
It looks to me kind of like Isaac meets Nuclear Throne. Like, it's more Isaac than it is Nuclear Throne, in my opinion.
I don't know if it's going to take off to the level of those games. I kind of hope it does, just because I think it does look so interesting. But I don't know. I'll find out. I'll probably talk about it next week after I've played it a bit.
Week on Dragon Ball Z.
Unless I end up refunding it or something, because...
Brett gets a game that he hyped up last week and tells you about it.
Does he like it? Maybe.
We but hope yeah. so.
That's about it. That game looks cool, though. Enter the Gungeon. You guys should check it out.
It does. Yeah, I've seen a little bit of it.
For a while, yeah.
I only saw it today, just by chance.
It looks pretty good.
Mm-hmm. So this has nothing to do with anything you were talking about, but you were using the word division frequently earlier when in reference to Street Fighter V, I believe.
Yeah.
And that just made me think. I have some friends who've been playing the Division at work.
Call of Duty.
Yeah, oh yeah, Call of Duty. And the interesting thing about The Division, it sounds cool. It's like a weird MMO, but it's based in like the real world. It's based around like a Tom Clancy thing.
Yep, that game sucks.
Yeah, so the only thing that I wanted to say about it is, well, you know, I have some friends, they get really into a game and then they'll just like, you gotta play it, and then they stop playing it like a week later.
That's that game.
That's yep. that game, yeah.
All of my friends at work are like, gotta pick up The Division. I was like, maybe I'll wait. I don't think any of them are playing it anymore. And when I mention it to them, like, I'm like, oh, are you still playing The Division? They, like, seem, like, guilty about it. They're like,
Modern Warfare. I'm lucky that I sold it on eBay for about the same that I paid for it. That game is so boring. Holy shit. Because, you know, you got this MMO-style third-person shooter, but it's in a Tom Clancy universe, so everything's, like, got to be sort of grounded in reality. And so you're just fighting these... I think I spoke about this on the podcast, actually. You just fight a boss, and his name is, like, Alex the Merciless. And he's got a yellow health bar. Wow.
Alex. Alex
he's wearing
the Merciless.
A shield or, like a... I don't know. It's so stupid.
Well, that's the thing. I think I brought this up, too, and maybe I forgot that we talked about this, but that was the whole idea. Like, those types of games lend themselves more towards a fantasy genre, but, like, they just try to, like, shove it into a Tom Clancy-type story... Because yeah. it has the Tom Clancy name on it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's like you can always escalate it in some interesting way in a fantasy universe, or at least go on an interesting tangent, but... what do you... I don't know.
Exactly. Well...
It's a weird idea. I haven't talked about what I've been playing.
That's what I was going to say. Go, Keith.
Justin, I should have trusted your hostful...
I wasn't going to cut you off, man. I wanted you to tell us what you've been playing.
I haven't really been playing anything. No. I've been playing Rocket League. I played some today, and that game, like, I'll get real mad when I'm losing, I think. Not always, but sometimes. I need to win one before I go to bed or something. But I'll get, like, probably more angry than I should. It's certain, like, not as bad as some people, but just, like, if I keep losing. But anyway, today... I was just playing people, and I think, like, it put me down a rank because I was just playing, like, terrible people today. I had, like, one loss, but then I had one where I scored 3 goals in the first 7 seconds of the match.
Damn.
I just, every time, and it wasn't that he was, like, AFK, every time he, like, went for the ball and then totally, like, whiffed it, and I just... like, went for the jump shot or whatever and just nailed it right across this field into the goal three separate times. And then I played someone after that, and my teammate dropped immediately, and I beat 2 people by myself. And I'm not very good, and these people were just awful. I think it just put me in, like, a really shitty group. And because it did tell me yesterday, like, oh, you've downranked or something, which I don't really care about. I just like playing, but...
Oh, so you've played the ranked mode now?
Mm-hmm.
How do you...
Now I only play the ranked mode, pretty much. Because why would you play the other one, I guess? Maybe you get into a game faster or something, but...
Yeah. What have you...
I bet you told me about that.
What did you calibrate at?
I don't know what that means.
like your rank in the game.
Oh, well, okay, here's the thing, is that I've been playing, like, all 4 of them, you know, and I don't... I know I've ranked on, like, one of them at least, but I don't know what it is.
Okay.
I could check and tell you. And I think some of them I haven't ranked yet because, like, it'll randomly be picked between the 4 of them, so I've got to play, like, 40 games or something.
Yeah.
Where all of them will be ranked.
Yep.
But it's a blast. I played with my brother and some of his friends, like, 3-on-3 private match the other day, and I hadn't done that before, and we were all on, like, Google Hangouts. That was pretty sweet. I've been enjoying that. And I played the Final Fantasy 15, I guess not a beta, but like a demo yesterday. And it was so interesting because, like, you don't see demos of that of games very often. It's just, I don't know, like Japan. And the other interesting thing is, I believe it's totally distinct content. That content is not in the game, I don't think. Huh. It's like a flashback, and it's not like, I mean, it's not like an amazing story, but it gives you backstory about like this kid you're playing in, like the, you know, this kid's dreamscape or something, and he grows up to be like the hero, and or he's like dreaming that he's a kid again, and so it's like talking about kind of his family life and everything, but it's plays a lot like Kingdom Hearts, except you can hold down the attack button and you keep attacking, which is a little dumb. And I think that was maybe a decision they made to make it more cinematic or something. Like, you know, you just hold down circle and he continues the animation. So I don't know if I like that, but he, you know, you still gotta, you like gotta dodge attacks and stuff like that. In between, and you have magic that you can use, and you have this warp ability, so you have to like warp away from them when they are doing certain attacks, and you can warp up to high ledges and you warp back, and if you warp a long distance and attack an enemy, you get like an extra combo, I don't know, like a damage multiplier. And it seems like there could probably be, and this is just like initially, you know, and so if they add other stuff in the game, which I'm sure they will, I have a feeling the combat will have a decent amount of depth, I hope, I don't know. And I enjoyed it. And the other thing that's cool is that you can save, like, your character, I guess, and or, like, you can move your progress from this demo to the actual game when it comes out, and there's an exclusive summon, Carbuncle, that you get in the game if you beat the demo and then import it. That's pretty awesome. Like, if you're interested in the game, it's just one of those things, like, why wouldn't you play it? But it's just kind of neat. It looks really nice, and I mean, it wasn't like amazing. I mean, it's not like amazing, but it's just like, hey, yeah, like kind of a tech demo, but kind of a story. Like, there are weird buttons on the ground that fast forward time so you can see the day and night cycle, and they will change the weather from like sunny to raining to cloudy, and so it's like part tech demo. So in that way, it's not like amazing game content. They didn't want to like subtract anything amazing from the game, but it does, you know, it's just an hour and the combat and it is fun, so I like it.
Cool.
Now,
and Binding of Isaac, and I don't know anything else.
I was gonna ask, I'm like, no Binding of Isaac the past 2 weeks. I guess you're on vacay, but
oh, and you know what else, I went to Toledo and we played a ton of Smash Brothers and Mario Kart.
Nice.
That peppers it.
Well, I was sick this week, so I wasn't really playing too much out of the ordinary, but I wanted to comment on, we're talking about Final Fantasy, and I was never really on the Final Fantasy train, you know, as we've talked about in the past, you know, until very recently. Turn-based games haven't really been my shtick. But beyond that, I kind of equate Final Fantasy storylines to how that one time I talked about Metal Gear Solid. They're the kind of games that I feel like try to be kind of deep sometimes, and then you kind of look at it and you're like, this man is holding a sword larger than himself. Like, how seriously can I realistically take this? I just have trouble getting immersed in that because the characters just, they're so, like, they really lay it on hard with some of the weird preachy lines and like the really dramatic.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just don't like it. And I feel like Metal Gear Solid is similar to that. And that's like, that's the kind of vibe that I can't really get behind. And I think a lot of it comes down to, and I don't mean offense by this, but it's more of a Japanese type of storytelling. And you see it a lot in Japanese anime where it's like, it's so overdramatic. And to me, it just, the characters just don't come across like real people, which is why I could never really get into it.
I'd say that's true. It's like, in Kingdom Hearts, like Final Fantasy Kingdom Hearts, Metal Gear Solid. Well, Metal Gear Solid is really, I mean, it's different, but, you know, similar in the ways you're talking about. Like, over dramatic, over the top kind of storytelling. And I don't know what it is. Like, Final Fantasy 13, and I could see, like, oh, you made all these characters and you tried to make them all interesting and unique. And maybe it's just that I was older, but, like, it just all seemed kind of two-dimensional, or
like, or one-dimensional, I guess. I don't know what the term is. And they, you know, it's just like, this child's name is Hope, and he is, he is shy, but he wants, I don't know. This guy, you know, and it just seemed like all of them had one defining character trait.
Yeah.
And I didn't care about any of them. And the past thing that I thought was really cool in Final Fantasies, it was like, it's like a formula, but it was a formula that I loved, is that in the games where they really did it well, Final Fantasies and Kingdom Hearts and stuff, is when you think the world is one way and you start off doing something, and they, you know, they kind of set up the rules and they set up the threat and they whatever, and then 2/3 of the way through the game, or, you know, halfway or something, they totally flip it on its head, and it's just like, okay, none of this is what you think it is, like, and it's to such a fundamental level. And I don't really need to spoil things for an example, but who the fuck's gonna play these things? I don't know, like, you find out in some Final Fantasies, like, hey, the main character is not who you think he is at all, and he has a totally different backstory, and he's totally, like, fucked up mentally, or I can actually think of several games that Final Fantasy games that do that, or like there's some ridiculous strange force that's at work in the world, and like the villain that you're fighting isn't the real villain, and there's a lot more at stake and things like that. And I really like that. There was just some point in the story where you just go, oh fuck, like, what?
Yeah, that's and, some good stuff.
And I like that when they in a movie or a game or whatever, when they set up rules and then they totally turn them on their head. Makes me want to tell you about a movie that I just saw, but then I'll kind of spoil it because you know what I just said, so I'm not gonna say it.
I want to know.
No. I'll tell you. All right, if you people, I don't know,
is it like new, is it a obviously new film, is it a brand new film?
Yeah, it's just, I mean, that's not that much of a spoiler, like, but it's pretty cool. It's the Cloverfield Lane one. See you there. It's kind of cool in that way, but I think other people didn't appreciate it based on, sorry, I like finished it. We went in the bathroom. I was in the bathroom, and the guys at the urinal next to me were like, man, that movie sucked. the ending, that was, or like, you know, like when it, you know, 2/3 of the way through the movie, oh, that was stupid. Like, Batman versus Superman was better than that. I was just like laughing to myself.
Oh, I could talk about that movie.
It was just pretty, it was just kind of cool. But, yeah, I don't know. I couldn't get into Final Fantasy 13. I couldn't get into Final Fantasy 12. They just like threw these characters that I felt like God, people worked really hard on them, and I just do not care. And I mean, and I couldn't really figure out why. But maybe it's just because I'm older. But Final Fantasy 15, everybody's looking at it, and I mean, they've been working on this game for like 10 years, and I feel like this is a lot of people's last hope for the Final Fantasy series, because it looks like amazing gameplay wise and the world is beautiful, and I just, people are really hoping that this game is, you know, reminds them of the rest of the series.
That's reasonable. People look back, I mean, the reason Final Fantasy is still being made is because people remember Final Fantasy as being one of the coolest genres or series that they've played.
I just don't understand how, like, you know, like Square Enix can afford to work on these games for like 10 years, like Kingdom Hearts 3, Final Fantasy 15. They've been working on them for like fucking 10 years.
Yeah.
How do you stay in business? Are you making, like, I know, I feel like they put them on hold a lot and then start them back up and stuff, but I just, really strange thing.
I mean, they have other games, right? And like, I know there are Final Fantasies that are MMOs that are probably self-sufficient.
Yeah, they've certainly put out other games in the meantime, but it's just really strange. Like, why don't you just finish the game instead of like waiting, putting it on hold and waiting so long, and then, oh, a new console's out, so you have to totally convert the source code over and make sure it works on this new thing and waste a bunch of time.
Yep.
But
I feel like that's what's about to happen with the new Zelda.
Nah.
They had better put it on like Wii U, and I know this sounds stupid. It sounds dumb. It, like, when you think about it at first, but like, there could be a lawsuit because a lot of people only bought a Wii U so they could, because the Zelda game is promised on it. When you think about it, that is like selling a product, I mean, under false pretenses.
Yeah.
Some people didn't buy a Wii U until they announced the new Zelda, and then they did because that's everybody's favorite game on that system. And but I mean, they're still saying they are, so I believe they're going to.
Yeah, I mean, I won't jump to conclusions. I agree with you though. They better do that. Like, if they change that, they're going to be in for some serious public backlash.
Yeah,
more than they already are.
Yeah, right.
Did anybody see Batman versus Superman?
I did not. No.
I was going to ask you about this. I did not see it, and I don't plan on seeing it, but I do watch. You know the guys that did those Star Wars prequel reviews? The really stupid...
Oh my god, yeah. Did you do a review
So they do reviews of all sorts of different films. I mean, it's not in the same mannerism as the prequels, but they just do like their own little review series. And I watch them, and it's pretty fun. And I don't know, I watch them on Batman v Superman. And because I had already heard some things about it, so I decided to watch theirs, and I don't think I plan on seeing it at this point. But I know of the film. I suppose we won't talk about spoilers because it's a pretty new movie. Did you see it, Brett?
Yep.
What'd you think?
I thought it was fucking terrible.
Okay. I was afraid you're going to be like, well, I liked it.
Nope. That movie was so goddamn bad. I haven't worked this out, but Zack Snyder just masturbates himself over and over in his films where he's like, oh, I'm going to tell a Batman origin story for the 16th time because, all right, so everybody knows how Batman becomes Batman. His parents die and he gets scared by bats. Ooh. But I'm going to do it different, guys. I'm Zack Snyder. And so when the man pulls the gun up to his mom, I'm going to have the pearls wrap around the gauge of the gun, and the pearls are going to break and the pearls will go everywhere. And people will be like, oh my God.
Didn't that happen in the original? I think that happened in the original Batman.
It's so good that I'm going to put it in twice in the film because they didn't see it enough times.
That exact thing happened in the Michael Keaton original Batman.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. The pearls. Zack Snyder thought he could do it better, so.
You had to like put it in twice.
There's scenes like that throughout the film. They add nothing.
He did Superman.
Man of Steel.
Man of Steel.
Was also not received well.
Here's the thing. Like, I don't know. I don't want to offend anybody, but I feel as though I'm very forgiving of movies. I know I say that a lot. But I can really, like, enjoy movies that not everybody else. I mean, like, the Indiana Jones movie and the Crystal Skull, for instance, I was like, oh, that was the worst thing ever. I just walked out and I was like, eh, you know, that was entertaining, but it wasn't anything great. But that's how I felt. So that's an example. And Man of Steel, it was one of the worst movies that I've ever seen in my life.
Wow.
I thought that was so horrible. Jen and I were watching that on like a cruise ship, and like part way through, probably a third of the way through, like we just look at each other and we're like, this is awful, right? Like, this is terrible. They have like three separate times. That's Zack Snyder too, right?
Yep.
I think I just don't like Zack Snyder's movies.
I mean, I don't.
And some of them like 300 and Watchmen, people like those movies, but they're all style, and those are entertaining, but they're all style and no substance. There's nothing under the surface there. It is all flashy visuals and, you know, colored filters over the screen and, like, grittiness. And, I mean, I think the only good parts about Watchmen came from the source material, and a lot of people who really liked Watchmen were still upset with it, which isn't saying much because fanboys always are. But in Man of Steel, they just – or go ahead, Brett, sorry.
I was just going to say I was super disappointed with Watchmen when it came out because I loved the graphic novel.
And it's like – that's entertaining. That's – you know, that wasn't – that was
yeah, it had its moments.
Pretty good. And I didn't read the graphic novel, so I mean, if I had, I might have been upset with it. But Man of Steel, they have like three separate times, three separate natural disasters. Like, how many fucking times does he have to learn the lesson? Like, oh, I should save people. There's a tornado. Now there's a big fire. Now there's a flood. Like, you just thought of every natural disaster at three separate flashbacks, and the acting is terrible, and it was just so bad.
Oh, yeah, the guy who plays Superman is bad.
And apparently he just loves, like, breaking the rules, like, set up in the comics. Like, it just seems like he has a... I mean, people say this, and I don't, you know, didn't really read DC Comics that much, but, like, he just loves having Batman and Superman kill people.
Yep.
And they don't do it in the comics, like, I don't know. I guess there's one comic where Batman, like, kills someone, but it happens, like, once, and several times he's like, guns are the tools of our enemies and we don't use them, and this is, like, the whole point of my character is that I'm fighting people with guns and I'm not using guns, and that's why I'm cool.
Yeah.
And I don't know. It's just...
Besides being dressed like a giant bat, Batman's whole thing is he doesn't kill people.
I know.
That's his thing.
I'm somehow still scary, and I don't kill people, but, you know, villains are still terrified of me. That's his whole thing.
He straight up murders in Batman versus Superman. Like, he's blowing up cars with, like, four people in them, and, like, what the fuck?
That's too bad. To
me. I mean, it's to be expected. That movie did really poorly critically. I didn't expect to like it, but my friend was like, you want to go see it? I was like, I guess. I don't usually subject myself to movies I don't want to see, but... When in Rome, you know?
Yeah.
That's the saying.
I mean, I was talking to my friends at lunch today about just superhero movies in general, and I think DC Comics has a lot of really stupid IP that they're, like, trying to shoehorn in that doesn't really belong in, like, the modern genre of superheroes, unless you're just straight up being honest and being like, look, just you have to just suspend your disbelief here. Like, we're not going to try to make it seem like Superman actually exists in the real world such that, like, you could imagine he was here today. You know what I mean? Like, that's kind of what I feel like Batman v Superman is. They're like, yeah, imagine as if this actually happened. And there's one superhero trilogy that did that well, and that was the Dark Knight trilogy, because it was all technology-based and there were no actual superpowers involved.
Yeah.
And that's the only one that I think did it okay, where you're like, okay, like, there's still a suspension of disbelief, like, with the Scarecrow gas and that kind of stuff, and, like, Ra's al Ghul and all his weird shit, but, like, for the most part, you're like, yeah, Batman, he's just in a big suit that has all these gadgets. It's not like, he can fly, and he's from another planet, and he wears a literal fucking red cape. Like, that's the kind of stuff, like, I understand Batman wears a cape, but, you know, it's black, so he's dark and gritty, so it kind of fits, but, like, no one wants to see an Aquaman movie.
Nope. And
maybe that's what I'm getting at here. Nobody wants to. I know that was a non sequitur, but no one wants to see an Aquaman movie, and they're fucking making it.
And he's and, like, I love Jason Momoa, but, like, yeah, he's gonna do it if you give him, like, a ton of money. And I guess Zack Snyder was like, you know, people are, like, upset about the Aquaman movie, but, like, what people don't understand is Aquaman's trident can cut Superman, which is really cool. And you're like, okay, so right off the bat, the coolest thing about this character that you, the director of the movie, can think of is the fact that his fucking trident can cut Superman, who's another... Oh, my God. Like, the coolest thing about him is not even him, is what you're saying. It's not even the character. So right off the bat, what you're telling me is...
He's such shit.
You just don't care about the character at all. It's just going to be another shitty action movie.
Zack Snyder sucks.
So I guess along the same lines, maybe, I don't know, maybe we won't even get to the topic tonight because I'm on this now and I want to talk about it if that's okay. So you're talking about the Marvel Cinematic Universe and the DC Cinematic Universe. And I find, like, the DC Cinematic Universe, generally, it's darker. They try to be as realistic as possible. The Marvel Cinematic Universe is owned by Disney, and they try to keep it light and interesting. And, like, they're very clearly like, oh, this is just kind of a fun film that we don't expect people to really take seriously. Mm-hmm. And I don't think many people do. And that's why I think I'm like a semi-fan of DC Comics. I'm not an avid comic reader, by the way. But I'm just saying, I think DC has some really interesting stories. But... I think, and like, more so than Marvel, but the Marvel Cinematic Universe had their shit planned out. Because when you look at things, like, the Marvel Cinematic Universe had, like, tons of films that started small. Nobody cared about Iron Man. It just turned out to be a great movie. Mm-hmm. Because Robert Downey Jr. fucking stole the show, and everybody really liked it. And if it wasn't for that, nobody cares about Iron Man. Nobody knew who Iron Man was. And suddenly it spawned a whole new genre of movies that people now care about again when they hadn't for years. And that's what Marvel mm-hmm. did right, because now suddenly everyone wants to see superhero movies, and they're like, okay, well, over the next decade, we're going to release films up to the Avengers. And then they released the Avengers, and it was enormous. As opposed to DC, where they're like, okay, well, here's a Man of Steel movie. The next movie's basically going to start the Justice League. Like, within 2 years of each other, we have the Justice League. They just, like, super rushed it, in my opinion. And that's why I just don't think they're on the right down the right road. And also, when you think about it, DC has way more untenable heroes, because DC has people like Wonder Woman, who is literally immortal. She is an immortal hero from ancient Greece. How do you work with that? What do you do with that? Like, Iron Man is a guy, Captain America is a guy, and they have weaknesses. Wonder Woman is a fucking immortal. She's an ancient immortal warrior. So, like, how do you honestly portray that in the way that the Batman v Superman movie tried, like, the tone that it tried to convey? Like, look at these. They're real people trying to fit in, and how do they make things work? And I just don't see how it's going to work.
And they don't have... They don't... And, like, Thor is kind of a boring character, but he's, like... One, and they make him like the butt of the joke a lot of the time, or, you know, he's joking around, like, they give him a personality, and I know I haven't seen as many DC movies, so maybe that's why I just can't think of it, but I just can't think of the personality that these characters are supposed to have. Aquaman, Wonder Woman, Superman, what's their personality?
Yeah. Well, just it's interesting.
Stoic?
It's interesting you bring that up, because I was going to say something similar about Thor specifically. Like, of all the Marvel Universe stuff, Thor is the one that stands out as, like, the weirdest to me right now. Because he is from another fucking universe. And I understand there's the whole Guardians of the Galaxy thing, which they've sort of kept separate, smartly. But, like, he's from another universe based on Nordic mythology. That's one that I just will never understand. I just will not get it. Like, all this stuff like, oh, Iron Man and all these people trying to destroy the world. It's like, well, there's a literal god universe. So does this matter at all? At all?
Yeah. Just at some point, someone who did the comics was like, I know that this character is in an entirely different world, and he's totally unrelatable and different, and he's a god, but let's have him meet up with the Avengers. And, like, somehow it just kind of took root, and then everybody was like, yeah, Thor. Sure, he's there.
And I don't mean to be, like, super critical, but I think maybe this is from the perspective of someone who has not been a longtime Marvel or DC fan. I don't read a ton of the comics. So, talking about them, this is from the perspective of someone who's going in from a more casual basis, and it just seems so absurd to me. Like, I understand. I like superhero films. They're fun, and I think when they try to make them not fun and, like, super gritty and real, you either do it right, like The Dark Knight, or it just sort of bombs like Batman v Superman.
And is it like a coincidence that, oh, well, okay, who's the one DC character that everybody universally loves? Batman. I mean, is that a coincidence? He's the one who's just a guy and who honestly, like, I mean, the only way that he can, I don't know, like, he can barely even hang out with the rest of them. When he's in Gotham City, he's totally disconnected from everybody else because they just don't make sense in each other's world. And usually his only role in the Justice League, or his main role in the Justice League, is to counter, like, Superman, and because he's like, because that's an interesting story, you know. Batman has to take on, like, a smart, clever guy has to take on a god, basically.
Mm-hmm.
I like the story, like, yeah, Batman has a list of all of the guys, you know, all the other Justice League's weaknesses, and he has scenarios for how he could kill them if he needs to. I think that's cool and that's interesting, because Batman has a personality. He's just a guy, and so his story is interesting.
And it's based on technology.
It's technology. Yeah, I don't know. His solution is he has interesting solutions to problems. It's not always just fight. Did you guys hear that? So Batman versus Superman was so serious that, and it was getting such terrible reviews that they spent $10 million updating Suicide Squad, because they said, supposedly, like, they portrayed it super jokey. Like, they have Bohemian Rhapsody in the trailer of Suicide Squad. I mean, it's a bunch of villains that they're forcing to work together. The whole thing is like a joke,
and they said supposedly every joke in the movie was in that trailer, and in reality it was just a super serious movie. What are you thinking? Why would you make that movie overly serious? It's got fucking Harley Quinn and like a bunch of villains forced to hang out together and the Joker, and like you're just gonna make it overly serious? What's wrong with you? Anyway, sorry.
Yeah, that's
I'm with
bizarre.
You on that.
You thinking?
But that's what I'm talking about with DC Comics. That's how they're aiming their movies. And DC Comics, I think, generally, like the actual graphic novels, tended to have very serious stories compared to Marvel.
Yeah.
Like very deep. The problem with that is then, like, what? How do you really translate that to a screen? How can I look at Aquaman or The Flash in like a bright orange and yellow suit and really take it seriously on a live action screen? You know?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I wonder how much the PG-13 rating gets in the way.
That too.
Yeah.
Because some of the Batman stories I've read are so fucking dark. Holy Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
They really get gritty.
Killing Joke? Oh my God.
Oh yeah, Killing Joke is so messed up.
That's a nightmare. Like, that's a cool story. I don't know.
Yeah, and it's great. And like, there's Arkham Asylum, which the game was based off of. Like, I think those games are actually a pretty good example of how DC should be representing their games.
People have mentioned... movies. And it might have been one of you guys mentioned to me how it's really interesting that the DC cartoons have historically been way better than the Marvel cartoons. Like,
yeah.
The Justice League cartoon is good. And, like, Batman, and, you know, with Mark Hamill as the Joker and Kevin Conroy as Batman, who mentioned in the chat? Was it Cerberus or Drac or someone mentioned in the chat? They were talking about Kevin Conroy and Mark Hamill. I mean, they do really well in the cartoons, which is interesting. And, I mean, they're not particularly serious. Might have something to do with it.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Yeah, and the Killing Joke is interesting because, like, you know, Joker is someone who you, like, kind of learn to love, even though he's a villain. But he's just, like, funny and, you know, and Harley Quinn. And it's just so, like, cool to, like, make you love a villain like that. And then just, like, remind you in such a, like, jarring way, like, that they're a villain. It's pretty cool. I don't know. But are any of you guys worried about the Avengers Civil War movie?
Oh, Captain America Civil War?
Or Captain America Civil War?
Yeah. I think that looks amazing.
I'm excited, but I can't think of any scenario where... I mean, supposedly the comics are really good, the Civil War comics, and I haven't read them. I just don't... Realistically, I don't ever see them, like, you're never going to have all the Avengers just fighting each other, like irreconcilable differences. Like, nobody's trying to destroy the city, so, like, what are you solving by like, punching each other? And
yeah. I don't
so
know.
I never see that happening, but maybe they'll handle it in a good way. And honestly, just, like, they have a lot of talented people.
The trailers they have out for it are really good. So it's getting me pretty excited for it.
I hope Spider-Man's good.
Hey, guys.
I don't like that voice. I don't know why. I
mean, he's a child. He's a teenager.
Hey, guys. Oh, so they're going with the teenage version? Do you know?
You know, you're right, though. Like, he is kind of he's sort of like a really young character.
Well, let's see if Marvel can do better with this, because every other Spider-Man film that has been ever released has sort of bombed.
Yeah.
None of them have been good. I think maybe the Amazing Spider-Man reboot was okay, but the second one was not good. I don't know.
Spider-Man 1 and 2.
Tobey Maguire did really well, didn't it?
I think it was okay, but that was like one of the first. That was like the first Spider-Man movie ever. So I think
it was like one of the first black superhero movies. Now that I think of it,
yeah. There have been four since then.
Do you remember like the dancing in the kitchen from Spider-Man 3? What were they thinking with that film?
Oh my God, 3 was a joke.
What happened with that movie?
I think that was like Sam Raimi left to his own devices.
Yes,
like,
exactly.
People let him do whatever he wanted, and like, he's the guy who does the Evil Dead movies, so he doesn't take like. He's the opposite end of the spectrum. He doesn't take anything seriously. He'll just, I'll just do this really stupid thing. You know?
Actually, have you, did you finish your point? I didn't want to.
Oh, yeah, I'm done.
Have you guys been watching Daredevil season 2 at all? Or did you?
Yeah, we're on episode, we got 2 more to go.
Is anyone else really sick of this whole, like, fad going on with superheroes thinking, like, oh, man, maybe it's not so great being a superhero. Maybe I'm the bad guy. I feel like almost every superhero story lately is about the moral conscience that they've got about being a superhero. I think there was some of that in Batman versus Superman, because, you know, the whole thing is like Superman's being challenged as a hero. Like, is he a villain? Blah, blah, blah. It's like, oh, I'm kind of sick of it.
Yeah.
Especially Daredevil, because I want that show to be good. But
every time that, well, and just sort of a false choice or something, like, I don't know, like, they're like, oh, the villains just get back out on the streets within a week. And you're like,
yeah,
that doesn't happen. And, like, I get that it's like a superhero movie, but the point is, and lots of shit doesn't happen like superpowers, but the point is to be like, it's sort of realistic. And I'm like, people don't do, like, it's in a real place, Hell's Kitchen, New York. Like, people don't just get out of jail after a week for, like, fucking murdering people.
And you know how they always say it? They always be like, oh, he'll just get off on some technicality. What technicality? He killed someone, unequivocally.
It doesn't fucking happen. Like, very, very rarely. Like, Casey Anthony or something. Like, Jesus Christ.
I just want a superhero show where they're not challenged as superheroes. Just be the superhero. Stop worrying.
Yeah.
I don't know if I should kill this bad guy. Then I'm the bad guy.
Just fucking do it.
Do it. Yeah.
They're like, oh, well, the Punisher, like, oh, he was caused by Daredevil, and he's, and I don't know. And then he's like, I don't know, I just think it's...
Great show, though. I finally finished season one of Daredevil.
So I've never watched it, and I've heard mixed things. I've heard people say, oh, it's the best thing, you have to watch it. And then I hear someone be like, well... Yeah, it wasn't bad. You know what I mean? Like, I hear either, like, really overly zealous or people who are just like, I mean, yeah, sure.
It's good.
Okay.
Yeah, I think the cool thing about season one is it kept getting better and better the more that you learn about the characters and stuff.
Yeah.
Wilson Fisk is an amazing character in that show.
Yeah.
Whew.
Weirdo.
Season two's okay so far. They introduced the Punisher.
The one thing in season two is, I don't know if I should. Well, basically, they introduce several plot lines, and from what I hear, and I haven't watched the whole thing, they don't necessarily they resolve, but they don't necessarily converge. And it's one of those things where you think, like, oh, there's, you know, sending out all these, like, tentacles of plot, and they're all going to converge in some really interesting way in the end. And supposedly that just doesn't happen because they're just too. Just basically just two extremely distinct plots that are almost completely unrelated from to each other, as far as I can tell, in season two.
Huh.
They're just, I mean, just two. I mean, it's the two characters on the thumbnail other than Daredevil, and they each have their own plot that's extremely different. I mean, at least it seems to me completely unrelated from the other plot, and I guess they both resolve, and... don't really interact in a meaningful way.
Do you mean Marie stealing in Breaking Bad? Do you remember that? Like, just like,
oh, yeah.
They're like, I don't fucking care, Breaking Bad. That was hilarious, Marie stealing in Breaking Bad, because, like, how low stakes can this plot line be? Like, people are fucking dying. Fucking meth, and she's like, oh, but she took a coat from
a tiara. It was a tiara.
Oh my god, I forgot.
You know what, though? Tara and I are rewatching it now, and I realized something. It still makes no sense in the context of the show. The only thing I can think of is it was supposed to be a relative crime to show how like Skyler and the rest of his family would react if he came clean. So it was like a reason for him not to come clean, because everyone was like, oh my god, she stole a tiara. Ah,
makes a lot of sense, actually.
But still, I don't know. Every time I've watched the show, this is my third time watching it, and it just still makes no sense to me.
I've only seen it to completion the one time. I rewatched the seasons before the finale, I think, but gotta go back. Great show.
Well, hey, we burned through our time without talking about our original topic, which is fine.
Good. For next week.
So our anecdote this week was, describe some scenarios, big or small, of things that you have always wanted to do but never had the courage to?
Whenever I'm driving on the highway and someone does something that pisses me off, I really want to just ram them off the highway, but
I've never had one day I'll work up the nerve.
I've never had the courage to do it. Ugh.
So I have one that I feel like is very fitting. Anytime I'm in a long line for a cashier and there's some person at the very front who's arguing about the price of something, I just want to walk up and be like, so what's the price discrepancy here? $5.50? Okay. And get out $6 and just put it on the counter and be like, get the fuck out of this line. And then go back to my place and wait. I've always really wanted to do that.
You should.
So
it's not about that, though. It's about the principle, Justin. You should know that.
Do you ever think, you know, let them finish up their transaction. You finish up your transaction. Or, I mean, maybe if you don't have time, you just go out into the parking lot, you get in your car, and you run them off the road.
You get on the highway, and you just ram them.
Follow them back to their home. Tie up their family, and you explain to them what their significant other, what they did. They held up the whole line, and
explain.
You make her apologize.
Explain their mistakes.
Then you go back to the store and finish up your...
It's so easy.
So easy. I've got two.
Okay.
They're just weird. They're not... like, it's just weird things that I kind of, like, I'll fantasize about and chuckle to myself. And one was, like, you know, everybody just, like, fantasizes about quitting their job. And, I mean, not my current job. I enjoy my current job. But at times, they have fantasized about quitting jobs.
Right.
And they, like, in you know... big dramatic ways, or just casually, like, you know, nah, I quit, and you just leave. But I think it'd be really funny to just do it, learn an entire, like, female K-pop song by heart and, like, the whole dance, and just in the middle of a meeting, just... And this is how you quit. You just turn the K-pop song on at full volume, and you stand up on the middle of the meeting table, and you just do the whole dance, the whole song. You do the whole thing until they physically stop you from doing it, and you ignore everybody the whole time, and you, like, kick phones off and stuff. You just do... Or don't even do that, because you could get in trouble for that. But, like, you just do the whole thing until they physically remove you, and that's how you quit.
Because who's going to stop you?
It'd be so baffling to everybody there. And there's just something interesting about, like, there's something that's very funny to me about, like, forcing a bunch of really, like, stiff people to just like, view something really strange to them.
I love this.
Just force them to watch it. And how would they, I mean... explain that. That'd be a story for the rest of their life. Another, which brings me to my other thing, which is lesser, and I should just do it. But, like, you know, the people at my current job, if people leave their laptops unlocked, it's like a joke to go on their messenger and then just message everybody and be like, I like pie. And that's just the joke. And, you know, just whatever. And what I want to do, and I want to do it to, like, I want to do it to my friend Brogan, but, like, whenever he leaves his, like, laptop unlocked, just go there and make sure he doesn't know it's me, and just type, like, a long, really bizarre message to everybody in the company, and just, like, just extremely strange, like, the kind of shit that I send you guys, like, hey, I've been keeping this secret for a really long time. My name's not Brogan. It's just Brogan Jumanji. My last name's Jumanji, and I've kept it a secret from you guys for a really long time because of the way I thought you'd react. Now, I understand that it's a 90s movie. I haven't seen it, and I don't care to, all right? I hope we can get past this and be mature and just, like, this long fucking weird thing and just send it out to everybody and just deny it because he'll know it was me.
Because really he'll know it was me.
People that'd be like, oh, can we just keep this chat on topic? I'd really like to do that. I think I will someday.
I hope they hear about it.
That's excellent.
Oh, shit.
I wish I had more. I really don't have any.
I want to get a puppy. I don't know.
Yeah, I do. I do want a pet. I would love to get a pet.
Oh, what do you want to do to it?
That's weird.
Oh, just a half. All right, that's fine.
What do you want to do to it? I'll give it a name and make it my slave.
I feel like maybe this is indicative of some underlying social problem that I may have, but every so often at work when it's really, really quiet, I just want to just go like, exactly. Just because I want to see the people to my left and right kind of jolt away. That's all I can think of. I just want to just,
And then just deny it. Like, just people like just don't look back at your computer. Just look back at your computer and just don't say anything. And they know it was you. They knew you just did that. But they say like, whoa, what was that? And then you're like, what? And where would it end? Like, would they do something? Would they like tell someone? Or you just screamed at the top of your lungs and alerted the entire floor and then just denied it? Another thing I want to do is get a pet and name it a human name. I know that's like not super original, Andrew. But yeah, just like that's one thing that I never stop. It never gets unfunny to me. Just thinking of all the human names that I could name a cat. Oh, this is. This is Carl. This is.
This is Carl. Justin the dog.
This is Kevin.
Yeah, I don't know why that's funny, but it is. That's way more enjoyable than I expected it would be to me.
This is my dog, Jessica.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
I'll just lay in bed and just think of all the human names that I could give. And some of them are, like, some of them are funny on a cat, but not on a dog, and vice versa.
This is my cat, Kimberly.
Sometimes
this is Derek.
I wonder if anyone else finds this funny except us.
Oh, I'm sure that everyone in the chat is hooting and hollering.
This is Michael.
Michael. This is Jonathan.
Jonathan. Please make sure you pronounce it correctly.
He doesn't respond to anything different.
No, you have to say the. Don't say John. It's Jonathan. Jonathan. Say the whole thing. Jonathan. Don't say Jonathan. He doesn't know who you're talking to.
It's Jonathan.
He doesn't know who you're talking to. He doesn't know what you're made of.
I can't come unless you say it.
Ah, jeez. Oh,
what a fun and sensual time this has been again.
Drachmunden always wants to tell people that y'all need Jesus.
Y'all need Jesus.
Yeah, he did say that, didn't he? Jesus, you know what? Let me tell you something. Jesus needs me. All right? I'm the one who knocks, or whatever that line is from a critically acclaimed AMC show that we were referencing earlier.
I'm knocking.
Justice League cartoon?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Justice League cartoon?
I don't remember that part. I remember when they said it in Breaking Bad, but not in the...
Thanks for joining us, everyone.
Thank you.
Are you guys going to say goodbye or what?
Wait, I have an idea. Goodbye. Okay, I'm going to do that, and then you guys... You know, do it a little higher, like, goodbye.
Okay.
And then at the end, we'll go, goodbye.
Okay.
Goodbye.
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 Goodbye. That didn't go as good as I thought it might.
I can't believe Skype hindered our ability to harmonize.
Yep.
What a garbage program.
Later, everybody.
Oh, yeah, bye.